Hi, heroes. Fasten your seatbelts, because Mighty Marvel is about to take you to a new dimension. It's the exciting interactive dimension, where you'll find your favorite Marvel heroes and villains on CD. Right before your eyes, we're about to turn your computer into a fantastic on-screen comic book, which will give you more than 80 pages of dazzling superhero action. Just look at all you're going to get. Your favorite Marvel thrillers with all new computer-enhanced coloring, plus extra backstory pages that weren't included in the original comics. Special panels offering exciting clips from Marvel's top-rated TV animated shows with fantastic interactive sound effects just for you. And would you believe that your own favorite superheroes will personally accompany you through each and every story? How can we give you so much, so fast, so generously? Hey, that's why our name is Marvel. How lucky can you be? You're about to see and hear one of Marvel's greatest stories as an all-new team of superpowered X-Men wage the battle of their lives in a tale that'll boggle your mind. For the first time ever, Wolverine, Storm, Nightcrawler, Colossus, Banshee, Sunfire, and Proudstar, they're gathered together from the four corners of the globe to help Professor Xavier and Cyclops save the original X-Men from the indescribable evil of Krakoa. Then, after you've managed to catch your breath, you'll see and hear the original X-Men risking life and limb in Comicdom's most famous locale, the Deadly Danger Room. Plus, the origins of Banshee and Sunfire. Oh, then when you think things can't get any better, you'll witness the first pulse-pounding meeting between the Hulk and Wolverine. I'd tell you more, but I'm too excited to go on.
Marvel Comics presents the new X-Men in Second Genesis, featuring Wolverine, Storm, Thunderbird, Colossus, Banshee, Nightcrawler, and Sunfire. Wenzeldorf, Germany. A tiny town turned upside down by the appearance of a most unique individual. The blue-skinned mutant Nightcrawler. His outward visage throws the villagers into a panic. They believe him to be a monster. Cornered on a rooftop, Nightcrawler finds himself with no way out. Realization that the terrified villagers would burn down the entire village to destroy him compels Nightcrawler into desperate action. With no alternative, he dives into the throng, fists flying. Eventually, he is overcome by sheer numbers, and the villagers cry for a steak. As the bloodthirsty town people prepare to drive a stake into the heart of Nightcrawler, a single commanding voice rings out in their minds, paralyzing them. The source of this mental command is Professor Xavier. He's looking for mutants, he says, and he wants Nightcrawler to join him. With nothing to lose, the young mutant agrees. In a military installation in Quebec, Canada, Professor Xavier waits for the appearance of the man codenamed Weapon X. When the feisty agent arrives, Xavier reveals that he knows of his recent battle with the Hulk, and that he is a mutant. The professor, it seems, has a desperate need of mutants. The Incredible Hulk in... And now... The Wolverine. Weapon X is intrigued by the possibility of leaving government service behind. He agrees to join Professor Xavier's band of mutants. When a Canadian official protests, Wolverine's deadly claws make it clear that his resignation is effective immediately. Professor Xavier's quest for mutants continues in Nashville, where he recruits old acquaintance Banshee at the Grand Ole Opry. Later, far to the east in Kenya, tribesmen pray to Aurora, the goddess of the storm. In a flash of lightning, the goddess arrives and agrees to bring rain to the tribe's crops. The X-Men in The Wail of the Banshee. The usual noises of mourning in New York are suddenly eclipsed by a piercing, high-pitched shriek. Moving at unearthly speeds, a man swoops low over streets filled with deafened bystanders. Howling winds carry the goddess Aurora into the African skies, where she is at home among the elements. Soon the raging sky rains down upon the croplands below, and Aurora lands to find not only joyful tribespeople, but also the enigmatic presence of Professor Xavier, who brings to Aurora an offer. Piercing the veil of fantasy inherent in Aurora's life in Africa, Professor Xavier offers her a chance to come into a different world. Sensing the sincerity in his words, she accepts. Professor Xavier's travels next take him on to Japan, where he recruits the powerful mutant known as Sunfire, and then on to a farming collective in Siberia. The X-Men in The Coming of Sunfire. High atop a building in Manhattan, a mysterious figure looks down with contempt on the citizens below. Soon they shall know the ominous tread of sunfire. When a runaway tractor threatens a small child playing in its path, simple farmer Peter Rasputin undergoes a startling transformation. With a crackling release of energy, the young man becomes an armored colossus, unflinchingly positioning himself between the child and the tractor.
Life was hard, but we were a family.
Paco Drizzi, it's a tractor!
Ileana!
The hurtling tractor collides with the armored form of Peter Rasputin and is demolished, leaving the young man and the girl he protects unharmed. As the dust clears, Peter is approached by Professor Xavier, who offers him a chance to use his abilities for the good of all the world. The young man can hardly refuse, and soon bids his family and friends goodbye. Arizona, on an Apache reservation, John Proudstar chases a fleet bison across the desert as he dreams of the time when his people were proud warriors. With a superhuman effort, Proudstar wrestles the bison to the ground, satisfied that there is still a man among the Apache. John Proudstar is startled to find Professor Xavier sitting behind him in the middle of the Arizona desert. Xavier reveals to Proudstar that he is a mutant and offers him a chance to join him. The hot-tempered Apache refuses, but is soon shamed into joining Xavier, who secretly wonders if his new X-Men will be equal to the task that lies ahead for them. Chapter 2. And then there was one. At Professor Xavier's School for Gifted Youngsters in Westchester, New York, a new team of X-Men assemble for the first time. Each has telepathically learned English and been given a costume fashioned from amazing, unstable molecules.